Students, now we are going to see preparation of ethers by Williamson synthesis method So by using Williamson synthesis we can prepare alkyl aryl ethers. So in previous lecture we have studied dialkyl ethers. Now in this lecture we are going to see alkyl aryl ethers are prepared from phenol. So first substrate, that is the phenol, OH group attached to the benzene ring. This benzene ring with alternate double single bond is there. So this is phenol. When treated with base, that is NaOH. Now this NaOH breakdown, how takes place? This Na plus and OH minus is formed. So this NaOH supply OH minus. At the same time, what happened? This oxygen is highly electronegative, means it attracts this pair of electron towards itself, and there is a formation of O minus attached to this benzene ring, and this H plus is removed by breaking of this bond. This H plus combined with OH minus, and there is a formation of water molecule. So I can write this minus H2O on the arrow. So this O minus combined with this Na plus, and here we get sodium phenoxide. So this sodium phenoxide, when further treated with primary alkyl halide, that is methyl bromide. So O minus Na plus attached to this benzene ring. When this sodium phenoxide treated with primary alkyl halide, that is CH3Br, due to presence of only one CH3 group, it is less steric hindrance is there, steric hindered molecule, means electron crowd is very less due to presence of only one molecule of CH3. Now how the reaction proceeds? This O minus attack on this CH3 and the bond breaks heterolytically. So this both electron goes towards this Br, and there is formation of Br minus combined with this Na plus, and this NaBr is removed as a byproduct. So what happened? This O is attack on this oxygen, attack on this carbon. There is a formation of bond with CH3 and attached to this benzene ring with the removal of Na plus and Br minus, that is NaBr is formed. Now see, once again I will revise this reaction. See, this phenol, it is acidic in nature because it loses this H plus ion easily. So this oxygen attached to H, during the breaking of this bond, these both electrons are goes towards or attracted towards this oxygen, and O minus is formed. This H plus formed combined with OH minus supplied by NaOH. There is formation of H2O, which is removed as a byproduct. Now this Na plus gets bonded with this oxygen, and here formation of sodium phenoxide. This is sodium phenoxide is formed, intermediate product, and this sodium phenoxide further treated with primary alkyl halide. So primary alkyl halide, when treated with sodium phenoxide, there is a formation of ether, and which is nothing but anisole. So anisole, that is a primary that is the ether which is formed from primary alkyl halide, that is methyl bromide. The other name of this is methyl phenyl ether. Methyl, that is CH3, phenyl, that is C6H5, benzene ring is there, and oxygen, that is ether. So methyl phenyl ether, again one more name is there, methoxybenzene. Methyl group with oxygen, methoxy group attached to this benzene. So these three names are very important and which are given to this compound, that is benzene ring attached with OCH3 group, is nothing but anisole, also called methyl phenyl ether, is nothing but methoxybenzene. So this is the method. By using this method we can prepare alkyl aryl ether. So phenol, when treated with NaOH, first it forms sodium phenoxide, and this sodium phenoxide further treated with methyl bromide, it gives anisole. So anisole is the most important ether. In the preparation of ether, this anisole is prepared from the phenol. So this is alkyl aryl ether preparation method by Williamson synthesis. Now if we take one more example, that is when sodium ethoxide. So what is the formula of sodium ethoxide? C2H5ONa. This O minus Na plus. Name of this compound is sodium ethoxide. When sodium ethoxide is treated with secondary alkyl halide, that is secondary propyl chloride. So see here, this is the three carbon containing alkyl group, CH3CH CH3, and in this three carbon containing chain, this chlorine is attached to the secondary carbon atom. So what is meant by secondary carbon atom? The carbon which is attached to two other carbon atoms to which Cl is attached. So this is secondary alkyl halide, and when secondary alkyl halide treated with sodium alkoxide, it does not form ethers, because if you observe this chlorine attached to the carbon atom which is further bonded to two methyl groups, means already electron crowd is very high, and there is a attack on this by this oxygen on this carbon is not possible. So this negative charge means electron reach this group or oxygen which cannot attack on this carbon, because there is electron cloud is very high, means it is a highly steric hindered molecule. High steric hindered means electron density is very high on this carbon, and that's why this oxygen is not attack on this carbon. So what happened? Due to not attack on this carbon, this oxygen, so I'm going to write this CH3 like this way, CH2H. See here what happened? This oxygen attract this hydrogen towards itself by using this negative charge, that is form the bond with the hydrogen. So what we get? See, this C2H5OH is formed. So ethyl alcohol is formed. First product C2H5OH, ethyl alcohol, plus see here this Na plus, and this during the formation breakdown of this bond, again this Cl is a good leaving group, means by taking these two electron it breaks the bond from here. Then what happened? So here by taking these two electron, this chlorine Cl minus is formed, and this Cl minus and Na plus combine to form NaCl. Now Next remaining product is there. So what we get the product here, see. So what is remaining? These two electrons are shipped in between these two carbon atoms. So here a double bond is formed. So here we get CH2 double bond CH CH3. So propene is formed. CH3 CH double bond CH2. So this is the CH3 CH double bond CH2 is formed, and the name of this alkene is propene. So propene is formed. Instead of formation of ether, there is alkene is formed because alkyl halide is secondary. So if by using or by Williamson synthesis we are going to prepare ethers, then primary alkyl halide must be required. If alkyl halide is secondary or tertiary, there is a alkene is formed instead of ether. So this is the one more most important reaction from the Williamson synthesis. But if we change this alkyl group, so if we change this secondary propyl group to this sodium, and this C2H5 is shifted with this chlorine, then we can prepare the ether. So by taking the opposite reactants, that is, we can take this sodium isopropoxide and this chlorine attached to this C2H5, means ethyl chloride. So by changing this alkyl group oppositely, then how the reaction takes place? See, if we change the alkyl groups, so if we take here CH3, this secondary alkyl group, if attached to this sodium oxygen, sodium and oxygen, that is O minus Na plus. So here we get what is the name of this compound? See, this is sodium, this isopropyl group, and with oxygen, so sodium isopropoxide. So I can write here the name of this compound is sodium isopropoxide when it is treated with sodium isopropoxide when treated with C2H5Cl. So this is the primary alkyl halide. Why it is primary alkyl halide? So instead of writing like this way, if we write this C2H5 like this way, CH2CH3. Now see, this carbon attached to Cl is further attached to only one other carbon atom. So that's why this carbon is primary one. So primary alkyl halide is suitable for the production of ether. So what is the reaction? What will the reaction is takes place? See, this negatively charged oxygen attack on this carbon. See here what happened, this is the Cl. So this negatively charged oxygen attack on this C2H5 group. And this NaCl is removed by the combine with each other. So this bond breaks heterolytically, and here we get its corresponding ether. So how we get its corresponding ethers here? This CH3 as it is, oxygen also as it is. Now this oxygen, they donate this two electron and form the bond with this CH2CH3 plus removal of NaCl is formed. So this is the ether. Here we get the ether as a main product, and the name of this ether is ethyl isopropyl ether. So ethyl I can write here the name of this compound, ethyl isopropyl ether is formed. Isopropyl ether is formed by removal of NaCl. So see here, by Williamson synthesis we can prepare ethers only when the alkyl halide must be primary. If alkyl halide is primary and the sodium alkoxide may be primary, secondary or tertiary. Any sodium alkoxide may be primary, secondary, tertiary. Then sodium alkoxide may be primary, secondary, tertiary, but this alkyl halide must be primary. Then only we can prepare its simple as well as mixed ethers by using Williamson synthesis. So this is also most important example of this Williamson synthesis.